Welcome to VLSI lecture series. I, Professor Ritesh Dholakia, is going to explain you package technology in integrated circuit. So to understand package technology in integrated circuit, these are my session outlines, where first I'll explain through hole package of integrated circuit. Then we will see surface mount package of integrated circuit. And after that, I'll explain contactless package of integrated circuit. So to understand this video based on packaging technology, let us begin it with through hole packaging. And when we talk about through hole packaging, in that we are deal with to place leads inside the hole of PCB, and we solder those leads which is there through hole the PCBs, right? So those leads that will go through the holes of PCB and we solder it underneath. Packages are made from either plastic or ceramic material, and in through hole package there are mainly three categories. One is SIP, that is referred as single inline package. Second is DIP, that is referred as dual inline package. And third is PGA, that is referred as pin grid array. And we will see all three categories in detail so that you can understand how those through hole packages are there in these three categories. So let us try to understand how single inline packaging is been there. So in IC package, having single row of leads is SIP. So here in this type of ICs, there will be single line. That is what we are dealing with to place it through all of the PCB. It has less number of leads because of it is having only single row. And you can see some examples that I have shown it by figure. So this is one SIP which is there with resistor. So this is what resistor integrated circuit, right? And in that, different resistors that is there with this single line. And you see in this single line leads are there which we insert inside of holes of PCBs. Second is TE series, which is used in television ICs, where you see single line is there, and this is what we are inserting inside of PCBs. You see these are the leads which we insert inside of the PCB. So there is only single line. This is one more IC which is there regarding thyristor, and this is what SCR's SIP, where we have single line only. You see 5 leads are there. And for automobile ICs, even we have SIP type of packaging, you see. So this is how single inline packaging is been done, where single line is there with leads, and those leads will be placed inside of the hole of PCB, and underneath we'll do soldering of those lines. Let us see DIP. So DIP means dual inline package. And in DIP, there will be two rows which is there with DIP, and these two rows that we will be inserting. DIPs are mostly used in educational institute. You will be finding in your laboratories, most of the ICs, those are DIP, which is what we are using it on breadboard experiments. So this is one DIP that you can see. So where there will be two lines, and both of these lines are having leads. That is what we are placing through the holes of PCB. On breadboard even we can insert it, right? So most of the ICs in educational institutes, that will be DIP. This is second DIP IC, which is there with power divider made by Texas Instrument. So here there is one row of 4 leads, and over this side there is second row of 4 leads. This is third IC, which is there with Philips company, and that is there for coder, right? So there are different types of coder which is there with Philips. It can be BCD coder, it can be Axis 3 coder. So different types of coders are there, and with that this IC is there. So you see there are two rows, and along with the two rows there are leads, right? And this is what 16-bit RAM that is there with DIP. So here one row is there, and over this side there is second row. So that is how DIP packaging is been there. Now let us try to understand third category, that is package grid array, that is there with through hole packaging. So in this package grid array, IC packages are having grids of the leads, right? So you will be finding there are many rows, rather to have two rows, and that will increase number of terminals. So they offer more number of leads. At max there can be 400 number of pins. Till now it is available in the market with 400 pins at max. It is better than DIPs in terms of thermal conductivity and power dissipation characteristics, right? So you'll be finding those ICs are very compact, and because of that its power consuming is very less. So its thermal conductivity and power dissipation characteristics is bit better relatively in DIPs. You see the example. So this is what basic form of it, where many leads can be seen. So if you see horizontally, there are three rows which is having leads, which we can place it inside of the PCB through the hole, and underneath we can have soldering. Second example is there where four rows are there, you can see. So it is having more number of terminals. This is what we are using it for CPU, and that is made by IBM company. You see here it is written IBM company. So IBM processor that is there with this PGA package grid array, and one more IC which is there with this PGA, which is there with Pentium MMX. So Pentium processor is there with this PGA category. So that is what we underneath through the PCBs, and below that PCB we can have shouldering of these terminals based on whatever requirement is there with the connections. Now let us see some other category, that is surface mount package. So in surface mount package, we don't insert IC through the holes of the PCB, right? So unlike through hole package, the leads of the surface mount packages are mounted directly on the surface of PCB. So here we mount this package on the surface of the PCB, and on the surface itself we can do soldering to have a connection. So they do not go through the holes or fit into the socket. They just placed onto the socket, and on the surface of that socket we can have soldering. Normally leads of the surface mount package is bent at the angle nearer the foot to the aid of the soldering to the surface of PCB. So you'll be finding their leads are bent at an angle, and that will be a bent at angle where it seems like it is a foot where we do fold soldering along with the surface of the PCB. And one more category is there with surface mount, that is ball grid array. And in ball grid array you'll be finding there are metal balls, and it does not have solderable leads. We just place on the PCB and we just press it on that PCB so that it can get stick on that PCB. I'll show you how those balls are there in example, so it will be more clear. By little pressure we can fix it on the PCB. It has many terminals, starts from 56 to 1312 number of terminals. So due to many terminals are there with ball grid array, it is commercialized in the market with more complex functioning of ICs. It can have packaging from multiple sides. It can have packaging with four sides, right? I'll show you with one side of packaging so it will be clear to all of you. So I'll show you some examples with surface mount package. So let us see the surface mount package. You see these leads, those are bent, right? So here you can see it is bent at right angle, so you can directly place it on PCB, and here one can have soldering, right? Few more examples are there, like this is OPAM IC with surface mount, where you see this lead is bent, so we can place it on the PCB, and here we can have soldering on the PCB. We don't place it through the hole of that PCB, right? In previous examples we have seen we were been having holes through it, we place it and we fix it, right? But here we just place it on the surface, and on the surface itself we do soldering of this IC. This is LED master, and here you can see these are the leads which we place it on the surface, and here we do soldering of it. Now you see ball grid array. So these are the balls which is there with this IC, and you just need to press it on that PCB and it will get stick on that, and there are many terminals you can observe, right? And here this is what Euclidean geometry type of ball grid array, but there can be random shape as you can see it in this figure. So there are many balls. So these balls are having contact, and that contact will get fixed inside once you press it by some pressure, and that will get fixed on that PCB, right? So this is how surface mount package is there, where we don't, with this ball grid array, we don't need to do soldering, but with the surface mount, we need to do soldering, and that is what we do it on the surface of the PCB. While with the case of ball grid array, there will be socket, and on that socket, we can directly insert by little pressure on this IC. Now, last category, that is contactless package. So when we talk about contactless package, then in that it does not have physical contact with PCB, right? So here we don't provide any contact with PCB. Here there will be contactless IC packaging. It does not have any leads as it is contactless IC, and it provides information wirelessly. So you'll be finding in that there will be RFID or there will be antenna inside, and via this antenna there will be communication of data with that particular IC. So you see, this is one of that contactless IC which is having very small size. You can see it is of size of 4.5 mm, right? So 4.5 mm rectangular shape IC is there, which is contactless IC. And here we don't have any physical connection, right? That IC will communicate with the antennas which is integrated inside. So let us try to understand how antennas are there inside. So you see, these are the antennas. So these are the loop antennas by which it communicates contactlessly, right? So here we don't need to have physical connection. This IC can directly communicate without having any physical contact. That is contactless package. But with contactless package, complex information cannot be communicated inside of the PCB. Why? The reason is when it radiates by its antenna which is there inside, there will be lower bandwidth which will be available inside, and that will be having some radiation even. So due to radiation effect, it is having lower capacity compared to through hole as well as surface mount ICs. So 99% of ICs, those are there with through hole packaging as well as surface mount category of packaging, and very rare ICs that is there with small application purpose, we use it for contactless packaging. So I hope that you have understood this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do give your valuable suggestions. The reason is your suggestions matters to me, and based on that, in future I'll make videos which will be solving your queries. So please give your valuable suggestions. Thank you so much for watching this video.